torsional shear flow. So guys, we have discussed torsion of shaft, right? So in torsion of shaft, we have seen our cross section is circular cross section, and we also have discussed hollow shaft. But in torsional shear flow, what we see most of the time, our cross section is not circular. You know, not necessary your closed section is a circular section. Okay, so in that case, and on top of that, our cross section is thin walled cross section. Getting mine? It's a hollow and it is thin walled. So we are not going to use the torsional formula directly. T by J equal to, what is T by J equal to? G theta by L equal to tau by R. So this is what the torsional formula, and it is applicable to torsion of shaft. Instead of that, this torsion of thin walled, torsion of thin walled section is covered by something called Bradweather theory. Okay, so whenever you have thin walled structure, and most of the time in your thin walled structure, your cross section is not regular. So we use Bradweather theory. Now, if your cross section is regular, if your cross section is regular, okay, a circular cross section, and it is thin walled, in that case, we can use this theory also. T by J equal to G theta by L equal to tau by R. It is from torsion of shaft, like it's a exact. Okay, and if you use for the same problem this theory, Bradweather theory, it will be approximated answer. You know, answer may, you know, closely you matching. Okay, but it will not match exactly, because in Bradweather theory we have certain assumption. Now, there are what all assumption we have. Warping is freely permitted, tau excess present, and every other stress component is zero. So only one shear stress present. Okay, remaining all are zero, and this tau xs doesn't vary along thickness. What it mean? See, suppose I consider this is my closed section, and this is my S direction. This is my S direction, and your axis is along X direction. Now, guys, tell me what will be the shear stress in this plane? In cross section, what will be shear stress? We have discussed earlier also. There is one question we have kept in, you know, torsion of shaft exam also. What will be non-zero stress here when it is subjected to a torque T? Lokesh, what is non-zero? Y, Z here, I have not written Y direction. Y, Z. Shakti Prakash. So how we write shear stress? Normal to this cross section is what? X. The direction in which it is? S direction. Exactly, Shitish, you are correct. It is tau XS. This will be only non-zero shear stress. Clear? Now, what another thing? You can see this is my peripheral S direction. Now, your thickness may vary. What I mean, here your thickness is T1, and if you go to any other section, your thickness is T2. Okay, so here there is one assumption, your tau XS, you are along your thickness direction, means your thickness is this. Along thickness, it is not changing. We know, right, tau is proportional to R, right, in radial direction. But we consider for that particular small thickness, tau XS is constant. Okay, so these are the assumption. Now, we consider one section. You guys can see here, it is subjected to a torque of T, This is what one small element of length d as dz we consider. Okay, so you can see on this small element we have shear stresses like this, right? So what is this tau x s, tau x s? Now sorry, we have considered here dz, right? Sorry guys, if we consider dz, then it is tau zs, tau zs. So if that is the case, then here also I will say tau zs, it will be better. Okay, so this modification I'll share when I share the document, tau zs, tau zs. Okay, so here z is my axial direction. The length of this element is dz. Okay, non-zero shear stresses are tau zs, tau zs. Is it clear, guys? Okay, now here suppose this tau xz is t1 and it is t2. Or anyway, from complementary nature, we can say this is in equilibrium, right? So what we see here, if you take the force equilibrium, if you take force equilibrium along z direction, what we see, this is one force and this is the another force, right? How this shear stress into area. So you can see here tau 1 t1 into dz plus, you can see this is going in positive direction and this is in negative direction. Okay, this should be positive, this is negative. So tau 1 t1 dz minus tau 2 t2 dz equal to 0. Okay, now guys, here this is known as what? This is known as what? Tau 1 t1 is equal to tau 2 t2 and it is known as q. This q is known as torsional shear flow. This q is known as torsional shear flow. Okay, now guys, here what we do, this is my cross section, right? So we take one small element of length ds, right? So what will be force, guys? And it is at what distance? It is rho distance from your center of section. So what will be force? What will be force, guys? Df will be q into ds. So what will be your dt? What will be dt? dt is what? The torque developed due to this force about your section, right? So it is exactly rho q ds. Okay, now guys, what I can do here, if I want the total torque, the total torque will be what? Integration of dt. So integration q rho ds. Now what we can do, we can multiply and divide by 2. Can we do multiply and divide by 2? Everyone, then what we see here, if you see your figure, what is this? This is a triangle. Agree everyone? It's a small triangle. What is the area of this triangle? It will be 1 by 2 rho ds. Right? That will be the area of this triangle. Yeah. So what we can do here, this is what is small dA. Right? Now, if you integrate, Q is constant, right? Q is constant throughout your cross section. Because Q is what? Tau 1 T1 is equal to tau 2 T2. You guys know it is analogous to continuity equation. What is A1 V1 equal to A2 V2, right? So here tau 1 T1 is equal to tau 2 T2 equal to Q. So this is analogous to your continuity equation. Now, integration dA is what? The total area. Now, guys, one thing you always remember. What is this total area? This is a thin wall tube, okay? What is this total area? Anyone? Is it material area or cross-section area? No. Pushkin, 2 pi r is wrong. First of all, it's not circular, okay? It can have any cross section. No, this area is what? See, small area was this area, right? This area. So this area A is cross sectional area. It is cross sectional area. Even it considered the hollow area also. It considered the hollow part. Okay, it's a cross sectional area. It is not material area. It is not material area. Okay. Material area will be what? Suppose it's a circular. Suppose this is circular. So what is the material area will be? 2 pi r into t will be material, a material. Okay, but what is the cross-sectional area? It is pi r square. Okay. You can say pi r square. R is mean radius. So clear. So this is the most confusing thing in this thin walled torsion. This area is cross-sectional area, okay? This area is cross-sectional area, not material area. In fact, it is a mean. It is a mean. Mean, okay? Mean means the it should be taken from midline. Okay, it should be taken from midline. Okay, so what we got here, T equal to 2AQ. This T equal to 2AQ is known as Brad-Weddow theory. Is known as Brad-Weddow theory. Okay, of torsion. Okay, so this is approximate theory for thin walled structure. Now here, what is the Q? Q is torsional shear flow. So Q equal to T upon 2A. T upon 2A. Now next, once you know this T, what is the important thing in torsion, guys? Anyone? What is the deflection in case of torsion? What is the deflection or deformation? Twist, right? Angle of twist. So the second thing which is important is angle of twist. Now angle of twist, how we can find in case of torsion? See, we know what is the strain energy stored in the structure per unit length. What is the strain energy stored in the structure per unit length? We guys know, right? The if you draw the diagram between torque and theta, right? The area under this diagram is what? Strain energy stored. So it is 1 by 2 T into theta dash. So theta dash is here, angle of twist per unit length. Okay. In case of thin wall structure, we use angle of twist per unit length more. Okay. Instead of total twist. Now, guys, what it will be in other way in terms of the stress. It is 1 by 2 tau gamma volume per unit length, right? Volume per unit length. Clear? Can I write like this? Because we know strain energy density, right? So strain energy density, why per unit, not per unit volume? No. See, here, okay, let's write it as 1 by 2 into theta. Don't get confused, okay? Instead of that, I will write 1 by 2 into t theta. Is it clear? Now, what is actually this? This is, we know, right, guys, 1 by 2 tau into gamma into volume, right? So, this is what here. Okay. Now, further, what is this gamma? Gamma is tau by g. So, it is 1 by 2. Tau square g, what is the volume? It is t into ds into 1, because here theta dash is what? Per unit length, right? So it is tau square by 2. So what is theta dash? The angle of twist per unit length is integration tau square by tg into tds. What is t? T is 2aq, right? What is tau? First, what is the tau? It is q by t, right? So we have substituted q square by t square. One t got cancelled, so it is. Now, what is the t here? 2aq. So final formula is what? The angle of twist formula is 1 by 2ag integration q by t into ds. Always, guys, this is very important formula, and in fact most important formula in thin world. It's a very easy, actually topic is very easy. So theta dash is always 1 by 2ag integration q by t into ds. Now g can be inside, a can be inside, may be inside if your different section has different g. Suppose it's a rectangular section. If it is a g1, g2, g3, g4, then we can take g inside integration. Otherwise, we can take out. Is it clear? Angle of twist per unit length is 1 by 2 ag integration q by t into ds. Clear? So we got two formula here. The two formula, one is what? My torque is 2aq. What is q here? It is tau into t. And what is your angle of twist per unit length? It is 1 upon 2ag integration q by t into ds. Clear this formula till now? Yeah, mostly g is taken out because g is constant. The complete cross section has same material. Okay, now once you know that, then another important formula in your this thin wall torsion is torsional constant. So my torsional constant is what we guys know, right? T by j is equal to g theta by l equal to tau by r. So this j is here known as torsional constant. And we told for circular cross section, this j is nothing but IP, polar moment of inertia for circular cross section. Okay. Now, if cross section is not circular, then this j is given by this formula. What is this formula? 4a square upon integration ds by t. Now again guys, here this area is cross-sectional area, not material area. Clear this point? Is it clear? Your 2020 question, your GATE 2020 question is based on this concept, based on torsional constant concept. Okay, we will do that question also. We'll see. Okay. Now, guys, once you know torsional constant, what is torsional rigidity? It is GJ. Right? G into J is what? Torsional rigidity. Clear?
Hello, sir.
Yeah.
Sir, what is meant by material area? Material area is whole section.
See, the material area is whatever material has, right? It is a thin walled. So where is the material? This is what the material, right?
Yes, sir.
So suppose it's a circular, then what will be material area? It is 2 pi r into t, right?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
But what is the cross-section area? It is pi r square, right?
Yes, sir.
So always remember, in torsion, the area must be taken cross-sectional area. Okay? Okay. Now torsional rigidity, so it can be written in this form. So it is 4a square upon integration ds upon gt. Okay, so this is what torsional rigidity. Now if you see the questions based on this, I have taken this question. Yeah, look into this question, guys. What is given? A thin walled beam of constant thickness shown in the figure is subjected to torque of 3.2 kilonewton meter. Shear modulus is 25 gigapascal. They asked angle of twist per unit length. Can we do? It can be done by two way. Okay. It can be done by two way. Anyone? One is what? Theta dash, which is angle of twist per unit length. We got, what is the formula? 1 upon 2ag integration q upon t into ds. Right? So how you will find first q? Torque is given, right? So t by t equal to 2aq, right? So what is
not audible, sir?
Am I audible now?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yeah, my display got off. That's why I was not audible. So guys, this question can be solved from that, right? So we know angle of twist is what? 1 upon 2az integration q by t into ds. Am I correct? That's what we have derived. You guys agree or not? And what is that q? It is t by 2a, right? So this formula can be written in this form also. 1 upon 4a square g integration torque by t into ds, or it can be written as t upon फोर ए स्क्वायर जी इंटीग्रेशन डी एस बाई टी। यू गाइस एग्री? ओके, सो वी गॉट ना दिस टॉर्शनल कॉन्स्टेंट फ्रॉम हियर ओनली वी गाइस गॉट टॉर्शनल कॉन्स्टेंट राइट। यू कैन सी हियर, so theta dash is what, t by gj right, this is what from that formula g theta by l equal to t by j. So what you guys got, j is what, 4a square by integration, j is what, 4a square by integration ds t. Clear? So now is it clear how we got torsional constant for section guys? Now can we solve this question guys? Torque is given. Okay. So let's solve this question. I will tell you a step. So finally, what is my theta dash? Angle of twist per unit length they asked. So theta dash is t square upon 4a square integration ds by t. Now here guys, it's a rectangular cross section, right? And what will be area here, cross sectional area? It will be 400 into it will be 400 into 100. So area is clear. Now what is theta dash? It is t square upon, sorry, not t square, it is t upon 4a square integration ds by t. It is t upon 4a square. Now integration ds by t is what? It is 2 into 400 and thickness is uniform. So it is by 2 plus 2 into 100 by 2. G is also there. Now is this step clear to everyone? Is this clear? See, you guys can see ds is what, peripheral length. So here you can see this is the length. What is the thickness? 2. So this is 400, this is 400. So I have written 2 into 400 divided by 2. Now this length is 100, this is also 100 and thickness is again 2. So it is 2 into 100 by. So guys, find out the answer. And they told answer should be in radian per meter. Radian per meter. So what we have to do? We have to convert first this. I think this and this will cancel. This and this will cancel. Area, please convert area and G in Newton per meter square. What is twist per unit length here? Oh, twist per unit length. Sorry. Yeah, got it. Yeah. So area is what? 400 into 100 into 10 to the power minus 6 meter square. And shear modulus G will be 25 to 10 to the power 9. Newton per meter square. Okay, so guys, and t is given as Guys, find out the answer. Theta does quickly. It came in gate 2020. Think you guys are writing gate 2020. Everything is given. This is one of the most important topic, thin walled torsion, okay, in your gate exam. This is the question number 11th, okay. I think one more, yeah, 11 times they have asked questions from this topic. So you guys are getting 0.01. Everyone getting 0.01. So good. Good guys. So I'll just do the polling. If 0.01 means yes, if it is no, then no. So let's do polling. Who all are active in class? Tower, what happened nowadays? You are not that active. Manas, Rohan, Mr. Himansu, it is not that tough, right? Everything I have written. Okay, so it seems some people, Aishwarya. Yeah, Jinesh, you have any doubt? Sir, I cannot match type since I am using mobile. My laptop has some issue. Okay. Okay, you can't type much. That is fine. But you can say yes or no, right? That's what I want to hear. Okay. Mr. Lovin, still I didn't get any response from you. Okay, anyway, let's publish the result. So yes, this is the answer. So I trust you all. This is the correct answer. So tell me guys, was it tough question? It was quite easy. Okay, it was quite easy. Okay, you must know properly formulas. Okay. So it was quite easy, so no issue. So now go back to concept part where we were discussing, yeah. So before moving more questions, we will discuss the remaining two concepts, multicell. So what is the multicell? You can see your wing, right? Wing has multiple spars, right? So you can see kind of and it is divided in multiple sections. So what multicell will do, it will add strength, right? It will improve your torsional strength, okay? It will improve torsional strength of the section. It will improve torsional strength of the section. So in multiple cell, again, suppose this my section subjected to a torque T. Then from Bradbeto theory, my T will be what? In my section 1 or my cell 1, suppose my torsional shear flow is Q1, in section 2 it is Q2, in section 3 it is Q3. So my T will be what? 2A1 Q1 plus 2A2 Q2 plus 2A3 Q3. Now guys, again from compatibility, of displacement, the angle of twist or per unit length of section 1 will be equal to section 2 equal to section 3. This is from compatibility of the displacement. Is it clear? How we are going to solve the question of multicell? This is my first equation, Bradbeto theory. This is from my compatibility of the section. Now here one most important thing comes. This is what common web, right? Okay. This is common web. This is common web. Now guys, tell me in this common web, what will be shear flow? What will be shear flow? Is it zero? Great, Himanshu. How it is zero? It not necessary to be zero. It depends from which direction we are coming. Suppose we are going from this side and coming from this side. Okay, we are coming from this side. So what will be my shear flow in that case? It will be Q1 minus Q2. But if I go like this, then what will be my shear flow? It will be Q2 minus Q1. So it depends on shear flow direction. Okay, from which side you are going. Okay. From which junction you are moving. Now, same way in this, what is the shear flow? If you come like this and go down, then it will be Q3 minus Q2. Clear? I have written the reverse. It is Q2 minus Q3. Now this can be negative. If you write Q2 minus Q3 is negative is coming, that means you are going in the opposite direction of shear flow. If it is coming positive means you are in same direction of shear flow. Clear? Is this clear? So Himanshu sir, aapne rat liya hai, theek hai? Aapne ye rat liya hai ki ek question aaya tha gate exam hai. This is one of the questions in gate where you are in this mid web shear flow is zero. In this mid web shear flow is zero because this section is symmetry, this side and this side. Okay, due to symmetry and the applied torque is T, in mid web shear flow will cancel. Okay, but it is not symmetric. Okay, so this is the concept of multi cell. And again, what is my theta dash, guys? Again, guys, remember this formula. Theta dash is what? It is. No, Q1 will not contribute in Q3. It will not contribute in Q3. Now, theta dash, what formula we derived? It is 1 upon 2AG integration Q by T into DS, or it is T upon 4A square G integration DS by T. Okay, so that is all about closed section. Whatever we have discussed till now, that was closed section. Now, torsion of thin walled open section. So, torsion of thin walled open section is again from torsional formula T by J equal to tau by R equal to G theta by L. Now, what is the important here? J. So, for open section, we find J by two method. One is sigma B T cube by 3, or it is the integration what is integration I think it is yes integration T cube by 3 into TS. Okay, when we will integrate this, if your T is non-uniform, like my thickness is varying like this. In this case, we have to integrate in this form. This is what J. And what is the tau max, guys? Tau max is always T by J into T for thin walled open section. Yeah, it is some logic. No, this is always remember. Okay, there is not much of logic behind that, and these are the worst. Okay, open section is least preferred for torsion. Okay, open section is very poor in handling torsional load. Okay, torsion, whenever you have torque dominant loading, okay, then closed section is used. Open section is not good in carrying torsion. Okay, so these are the formula where the most important is what? J, and then tau max. So based on this also, there are two questions in gate. Based on this also, there are two questions in gate exam. So what those questions? You guys can look into those questions. Yeah, this is one question, and before that also okay, after that one more question came, I think. Yeah, this is the question. So can we solve this question, guys? Look into question. Now you guys will ask, what is the B? What is the B, guys? Sigma B T cube, right? Now what is the B? See, this is the L section we have done, right? So this will be your B1, this is B2. Okay, and then corresponding thickness can be. Now in this case, guys, how many B? This is 1, this is 2, and this is 3. But for each section, B is how much? 100. And what is thickness? It is uniform thickness, right? So what is thickness given? Thickness is not given. Is it maximum? Oh, they asked thickness. We have to find the thickness. So what is given? Maximum shear stress. So we know tau maximum is what? T by J into T, right? What is J? It is 1 by 3 sigma B T cube, right? So here in this case, it is how much? 1 upon 3, 3 into 100 into T cube. So can we guys solve this question? And T is given. How much? Torque is given. Tau is given. Find out T value, guys. So what is the answer, guys? T is equal to square root of 6.25, right? Am I correct? Is this correct, guys? Okay. So yes or no, we will do polling. 2.5 is yes. Okay, what happened, Bhupender? Lovin, Bhupender, Sachin, Manjunath, Sachin. Tomorrow is mathematics class, Pushakin. Tomorrow is mathematics class. Okay, Friday is always mathematics class. And one more announcement, guys. Coming Diwali, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, we may not have classes. Okay. Friday, we may mostly will try to avoid, we'll discuss. Okay. So, coming weekend, we will give off. Enjoy Diwali. Okay. With green Diwali or whatever crackers you can crack, but in limitation. Okay. In IIT Madras, I was social affairs secretary. So we have celebrated Green Diwali there, okay? So how I convinced a student to not to use crackers? I am a Marwadi, so I tempted giving sweets, okay? We have celebrated very nicely. Lot many sweets we got from Marwadi shops, okay? Anywhere you go, you will see Marwadi sweet shops, okay? So we celebrated a nice Green Diwali and we got award also. We lighten many deeps, okay, many deeps that Diwali particular. And the another problem in Chennai will happen during Diwali, it will be rainy. So if it is rainy and in IIT it's a full forest, so if people use crackers now, your air will be like nothing will be visible, kind of thing will happen with the smoke. So that's good. Okay, fine. So can we move to next question? Polling, I think we have done. And we will publish the result. I think two people are not responding in class. Okay, so let's see this question. It is one of the good question. Okay. So it came in GATE 2017. In GATE 2017, but this question is more of, you know, aptitude question. Okay, can anyone solve this question? It is more of aptitude based question, not concept based. So read the question, what it is said. The idealized cross section, the idealized cross section of a thin walled wing box structure shown in the figure is subjected to an anti-clockwise torque of 10 kilo newton meter. The corresponding shear flow distribution under this loading condition is shown in the figure. the area of each cell A1 and A2 is given. The ratio of unknown X upon Y is. So what is X? X is shear flow in this web. What is Y? Y is this shear flow. You can see everywhere Y, this means this is Q2. And suppose this is my Q1. So what is here Q1, guys? And one more thing I want to tell, my torsional shear flow will be unaffected by boom. Okay, boom carries bending. Okay, skin carries shear. Okay, so this boom will not affect my torsional shear flow. Okay, torsional shear flow is always is unaffected by boom section. It is not affected by boom section. Okay, see, torsion in thin walled structure is carried by skin. Okay, boom carries bending always, guys. So here, now guys, tell me, what is Q1? What is Q1 here, guys? 5 ton per mm. What is Q? What is X? It will be Y minus Q1. Clear? So what is Q1? 5. What is X equal to Y minus 5? So what is X by Y? It is 1 minus 5 by Y. Am I correct? Which part? See, it is Q1. This is Q2 because it's a multi-cell. Now Q1 is what? It is 5, right? Because here there is only torsional loading. Whenever torsional loading, your torsional shear flow is unaffected by boom section. Okay, these are my boom section. So you can see, though this shear flow is crossing this boom, magnitude is same. So my boom will not change torsional shear flow. Okay, my boom will not change torsional shear flow. Yeah, I think 1.833. Now you guys know here everything, right? X upon Y equal to, now Y is unknown. How we can find Y? We know what T equal to 2A1Q1 plus 2A2Q2. Right? Now Q1 is already known, 5. Q2 is Y. So find out Y. So what will be Y? It is T minus 2A1Q1 upon 2A2 is what? Your Y. Lokesh, can you check calculation again? Clear? So I'll write it again. Everything I'll write. So we have two equation. One is what? T equal to 2A1Q1 plus 2A2Q2. So this is what my Q1. This is what my Q2. Here we know Q1 is 5. Q2 is Y. So my Y is equal to T minus 2A1Q1 upon 2A2. They have given A1 and A2. And I know here my X is equal to Q2 minus Q1. It is Y minus Q1, which is what? 5. So my X by Y equal to 1 minus 5 by Y. So what is the answer, guys? I think 0.67. Yeah, 0.645, 643, I think that is correct. Sachit, your answer seems to be fine. Anirudh, Sakti Prakash, Lokesh, can you check? Everything is known. Why mistake? See, the torque, please guys, change this T in Newton mm. So it will become 10 into 10 to the power 6 Newton mm. So I think, yeah, 0.643 is the correct answer. Now tell guys, is it tough again? It is more of aptitude questions, right? And it is simple, based on Bradbury theory, right? T equal to 2a1 q1 plus 2a2 q2. Now q1 is given, q2 is unknown, find q2, and then they asked ratio x by y. Yeah, I think 0.643 is the correct answer. So let's see the poll, yes or no, or true or false. 0.643 is true. Mr. Abhishek Nair, are you understanding this? See, now we have crossed October month. Now what happens, guys? Those who keep faith in themselves, okay, many people join, okay, but those who keep faith in themselves, they find good rank, okay? So whatever you have put efforts, these will be useful if you put efforts in next 3 months, okay? The entire result decided by next 3 months. There will be many candidate, they put last 3 months good effort and then they get good result, but there are some candidate, they put good efforts till 9 months and last 3 months they think, okay, or they become casual or whatever distraction, then they lose. So next 3 months is most important, guys, okay? Keep faith in yourself, put your best effort to get best result, okay? So fine, so the answer is that. And then let's move back. Yeah, this question, this is a good question. Read the question, guys. What they asked? The thin rectangular tube shown below is made of material with shear modulus G. Shear flow is calculated based on mid thickness dimension. Guys, this point is very important here. Shear flow is calculated based on mid thickness dimensions. If the free end is allowed to twist no more than this much, so this is what total angle of twist, then the maximum torque which the tube can be subjected to at its free end is, anyone? How we can do this question? The length they have given, total length is how much? 2 meter. So what is here theta by L, guys? Anyone? Theta by L will be how much? It will be 0.0727 upon 2000, then it will be in रेडियन पर एमएम, राइट, एंड वी नो थीटा बाय एल इज हाउ मच, इट इज टी बाय 4a स्क्वायर g इंटीग्रेशन ds बाय t. नाउ गाइस हियर दे मेंशन द शियर फ्लो इज कैलकुलेटेड बेस्ड ऑन मिड थिकनेस डायमेंशन. सो व्हाट विल बी एरिया, what will be area, or you convert in mid thicknesses, so what it will be, the dimensions will become this is 5 mm, so it will be 2.5, 2.5 will go, so it will become 35, and 3, 3 it will go, so it will become 57. So my thickness is, this is 5, 5, 3, 3. Right? So what will be area? Cross sectional area or material area, guys? It will be 57 into 35. Now, here what they asked? Maximum torque is asked. What is unknown, guys? Torque is unknown, right? And in what unit they asked? In Newton meter, okay? They asked it in Newton meter. So first we'll get answer in Newton mm, and then we can convert to Newton meter. So theta by L, it is already known, 0.0727 upon 2000. Now it is T upon 457 into 35 square. What is G? 80 into 10 to the power 3, then ds by t. So what it is? 2 into 57 by thickness is how much? Thickness is 5. Then 2 into 35. What is the thickness? 3. Guys, find out torque from here. What is the torque? What is the answer, Lokesh? Nitesh, where is Om Goel? Oh, you are there, Om. That's good to hear. Okay, good to see. So I hope you guys are not missing classes. So what is the answer? Yeah, in Newton meter it is 1003.5. In Newton mm, so in Newton mm it is coming as 3518 Newton mm, or it is 1003.5 Newton meter. No, Lokesh, you have done some mistake. So 3 got missed actually. Okay, so again, is it tough question? It is simple formula based question. And again, here also, what is the J? In this case, what is the J, guys? What is the J here? Yeah, first everyone, I will do poll. Is this correct? Yeah, we can find J value. So what will be J? My J will be 4a square integration ds by t. Everyone please find J here. If they asked in your gate exam J for this. So what is 4? What is the area? 57 into 35 square upon integration 2 into 57 by 5 plus 2 into 35 by 3. So how much? 1,021.38 mm^4. Everyone please check, is this correct J value in this question? So if you find J, then directly we can write, right? T will be what? Theta by L into G, right? T by J. So it will be G theta by L into J. Okay. So I hope everyone could get this answer, 1003.5. So let's do polling, true or false. Yeah, Jaros, you have any doubt? So what is the key in this question? What is the key in this question, Mr. Himanshu? I believe only one thing is the key to convert this thick to thin walled section. Okay, mid thickness. To convert mid thickness, Jaros, what is J? 35 equal to 4. I didn't get. Always how we have to convert to mean thickness. So always see, it is like this. The given is like this. Okay, so my midline will be like this. Out dimensions. Okay, so you can see the outer is 40. Outer is 40 and this is 5, right? So means 2.5 from here it is gone, 2.5 here it is gone. So out of 40 minus 2.5 minus 2.5. So that's why we got this as 35. Now another thing here, this outer is given as 60, right? Now this is how much? 1.5, and bottom is also 1.5. so total how much it will go? 60 minus 1.5 minus 1.5, so we got 57. Clear? J is 35. Okay, J value you are saying. Some people then found wrongly, then this is wrong. J is how much coming? 3, 4, 5. Yeah, I think that is correct. You guys are correct. So Bhupender, can you check? This is wrong. So the correct answer seems to be 3, 4, 5, 0, 9, 1 or 9, 0 around. Okay, I'll write mm^4. So they may ask in your gate question, what is the J value? Okay, because one time they have asked this question. So let's see. This is one of the very good question. This is one of the very good question. So before moving, we will be discussing here. What is the answer? In this case, we got J, and what was the torque? 1003.5, right? 1003.5, right? So it is true or false? And J is also 345090 mm^4. Nehal, you are saying false. Okay. I think others, few people are not present. Aishwarya and Lovin, it seems, by mistake. Okay. So let's publish the result. Move to next question. Yeah, look into this question. This is one of the good question, and we can do this also. Okay, so read this question. There are two design There are two designs proposed for a shaft of length L with a torque carrying capacity of T. Design I is a solid circular shaft, means design one is solid circular cross section shaft of diameter 30 mm. Design two is thin walled circular shaft of average diameter 40 mm. Yes, Aishwarya, you are present in class. Thickness of the wall in design 2 has to be determined such that the maximum shear stress is same in both the design for given torque T, so that same material can be used for manufacturing both the shaft. The ratio of mass of shaft using design 1 to mass of shaft using design 2. Can anyone do this question? You guys are getting. What is given? Both carries tau max same. So tau max 2 equal max 1 equal to tau max 2. They asked what? Mass of 1 by mass of 2. They asked the ratio of masses. So let's do this question and see the length are same. Both designs are of length L, right? So that means what is the mass? Mass is always volume into density, right? So volume 1 into density 1 by volume Okay, Aishwarya, now is that question clear or should I need to repeat? Okay. So mass, you guys know, volume into density. Clear? So that means your M1 upon M2 is what? V1 into rho 1 upon V2 into rho 2. And they mention both should use the same material. Okay. and both carries same torque. The torque carrying capacity is same and material is same. So means your density will cancel. So volume is what? Area into length, and length is also same, right? So finally mass ratio is how much? Area ratios. Now guys, what is these areas? Tell me guys, are this area cross sectional area or material? Anyone? Okay, how many say material? I am saying material is false. How many agree with me? Material is false. How many of you agree? Okay, it's very bad. Some people are agreeing with me. Material is false. Mr. Aditya, Aishwarya, I will explain. Jaros, no issue. I will explain again. See, material, it is material area, right? Mass, who can air have mass? This is the hollow, right? See, M1 by M2 is what? Volume into density. Now density is same because same material is used. Volume is what? Area into length. Length is same, right? So it is areas ratio. Now these areas will be what? Material area, because we hollow section cannot have mass, right? So these are material areas. Okay, these are material areas. So many people have to think, okay, many people have to think it, when you have material area, when you have cross sectional area. Clear? So whenever you find mass, it has to be material area, guys. It has to be material area. Clear? So what is the your design one? Yeah, some people has not responded. Okay, I'm not sure why they are not responding, but let's publish the poll. What is your design one? It is a shaft, solid circular shaft. What is the design two? Thin walled. So when it's solid circular shaft, area is what? Pi by 4 d, diameter is given, right? So suppose it is d1. When it is thin walled, what is the area? Pi d2 into thickness, 2 pi r into t. Clear? Now d1 is given, guys. D2 is given, but T is unknown. What is unknown, guys? T. How we can find here T? How we can find here T? From tau max condition. Exactly. So what is tau max? We know it is 16 T by pi d cube for solid, and for hollow tau max is how much? T by J. Right, T by J into T. Right, what is the J for tu? It is 2 pi r cube a one moment. Okay, sorry, I rubbed everything. No issue. I'll write it again. So what we got, it is 5 by 4 d1 square upon pi d2 t is what m1 by m2. Now what, how we can find t? So tau max r sam, what is the tau max one? 16 t upon pi d q. Now we know t equal to 2 a q for thin wall. Now what is the q, guys? What is the q? Q is tau by t, right? Or tau into t? Tau into t. So it is 2a tau into t equal to t. So t equal to t upon 2a. Now what is the area, this guys? What is this area? It is mean area, right? Cross-sectional area. Mean cross-sectional area. So I can write it as pi by 4 d2 square so what is my tau into t. Now equate, guys. This equal to this. So what we get? This is tau max 1. This is tau max 2. So 16 t upon pi d1 cube is equal to 2 t upon pi d 2 square into t. So my t got cancelled, pi pi got cancelled. My thickness t is coming as d1 cube upon 8 d2 square. If I substitute there, this pi pi got cancelled. So my m1 upon m2 is coming as d1 square upon 4 d2 into d1 cube upon 8 d2 square. So it's coming as 2 d2 by. Is it clear? Correct? 2d2 by d1? M1 by M2 is coming as 2d2 by d1? Yeah, so what is the d2? What is the d2? 40 by 30 into 2. So how much is the answer? 4 by 3 into 2. Please check all the calculation, guys. So what I did, I found the mass ratio and they have given tau max is same. So max 1 is how much? 16 T upon D cube. So it is D1 cube. Now from Brad Bedo theory we know. What is T? T equal to 2A Q. What is the Q? Tau into T. So tau max 2 is how much? It is T upon 2 into. What is my cross-sectional area for thin wall? Pi by 4 D2 square T. Now I equated here. I got T equal to D1 cube by 8 D2 square. I substituted here. We got finally M1 by M2 is what? 2 D2 upon D1 is equal to 2. What is D2? 40 by 30. So what is the answer? 2.68. You guys agree? Not. So tau max 1 we already know it is how much? 60 upon pi d 1 cube. Tau max 2 how I got? I know the torque for Brad Bedo theory. It is 2a tau max into t, right? So what is the tau max? It is t upon 2 into pi by 4 d 2 square. What is the last? See, tau max 1, tau max 2 we know, right? Now I equated, then from here I got T equal to how much? I have to write in more organized way, okay? Little bit I will try to write in more organized way. So it will be, you know, looking good. Clear? They have told your tau max 1 is equal to tau max 2. They have told, right, in question itself. Is it clear, Pushkin, now? So is this good question, right? Here we have to use multiple concepts. Yeah, I'll wait.
Hello, sir.
Yeah.
Sir, what you wrote, sir, T is equal to 2 AM Q1. A.
T equal to?
2 AM Q1, sir. Is it MQ1?
No. A mean. Okay. It is a Brad theory. 2 AQ. Here the mean area.
Mean area. Okay, sir.
A, it is suffix AM, okay? AM means mean area. Clear? Is this clear? Yeah, so let's do the quickly poll and then move to next question. Okay, so A is the answer. Let's publish the poll. So two people said B is the answer. So I'm not sure why they are saying the B is the answer. Okay, no problem. So let's see this question. This is again quite straightforward question, but what is the confusing here? What is the confusing statement? What is the confusion here? Read the question. The stiffened cross section of a long slender uniform structure member is idealized as shown in the figure below. The lumped areas A, B, C, D have equal cross-sectional area of 3 cm square. The web A, B, B, C, C, D, D, A are each 5 mm thick. The structural member is subjected to twisting moment of 10 kN meter. The magnitude of shear flow in the webs QAB, QBC, QCD and QDA in kilonewton per respectively. Tell me the answer, guys. What it is subjected to? It is subjected to what? Torque, right? And it is how much? 10 kilonewton meter, right? Now we know what is the T. It is 2aq, right? And we already know this boom will not affect your Q. Torsional shear flow will not affected by this boom area. So that means what? Your QAB will be equal to QBC equal to QCD equal to QDA, right? So what is your Q? It will be T upon 2A. So it is how much? Torque is 10 into 10 to the power 6 upon 2 into area is 200 into 200. Find in Newton per mm and then Newton per meter. What is the answer? D is the answer. Correct. Correct. So in two of the questions we have seen, boom areas will not affect your torsional shear flow. Clear? See, even without knowing, either A can be answer, D can be answer, right? Because all the boom areas are same. So, but the correct answer is the D is the answer. It is 200 into 500. Yes, you are correct. Area is 200 into 500. It's not a square. D is the answer. Yes, Anirudh. Yes, everyone. So let's do the poll. So what is the answer? D is the answer. Okay. So let's publish the result. Okay, so let's do this question. Question number five. What is given? The channel section of uniform thickness 2 mm. Shown in the figure, subjected to a torque of 10 Newton meter. If it is made of material with shear modulus 25 gigapascal, the twist per unit length in radian, right? So first guys, radian per meter. So we know T by J equal to G theta by L. So what is the theta by L? It is here T by GJ. What is the J? 1 by 3 sigma BT cube. So what is it? 1 by 3 into thickness is same, but it is 300 into 2 plus 600 into 2 cube. Find out, guys. Everything is known now. Twist per unit length. Everyone, please answer. 0.125. Okay. 0.125 radian per meter. So everyone, please, if it is yes, then true, otherwise false. Okay, so let's publish the result. So again, it's an easy question. Yeah, it was asked in GATE. Find the torsional constant of a ring of radius R and thickness T. Right, anyone can do this. So we have a ring of radius R and thickness T. Find torsional constant J. So how much torsional constant J? It is 4a square upon integration ds by t, right? What is the area? It is pi r square. What is the length of periphery? 2 pi r. What is the thickness? T. So what is the answer? This area is square, 4a square. So what is the answer? It is gate question. Okay, I think in gate 2008 or 2007 they asked. 7 or 8. Yeah, 2 pi r cube t. So for ring, your torsional constant is equal to what? Ip, and it is equal to Ip, polar moment of inertia. Okay, because it's what? It's a regular cross section, right? Ring is a regular cross section. So for regular cross section, your J will be equal to Ip. Okay, J will be equal to Ip. Clear? Is this clear? 2 pi r cube t. And another way, what was the way for ring? Your J is Ip and it is nothing but Ixx plus Iyy. And we know Ixx for ring is how much? Pi r cube t plus pi r cube t. Right? So it is 2 pi r cube t. So these are the two way to find torsional constant for a ring. Clear? Is this clear? Can we move to next question? Okay, let's see this question number second. So what is given? A thin walled tube of circular section, okay, of mean radius r. This is circular, okay. Here it is not, it doesn't seems to be circle, but actually it is exactly circle, okay. Of mean radius r has central web, okay, like this. Which divide it into two symmetrical cell, a torque on acting on the section, the shear flow in the central web. A torque of M, okay. It is zero, right? It will come as zero. How we can prove it is zero? So see, for circular section, sorry, multi-cell section, your M is what? 2a1q1 plus 2a2q2, right? But we also know, right, what is your theta 1 dash is equal to theta 2 dash, right? The angle of twist will be same. Okay, so what is theta 1? It is 1 upon 2 a1 g integration q ds by t equal to 1 upon 2 a2 g integration q ds by t. Now area will be same, right? Both g is same, thickness is also same, right? So what we got? QDS integration 1 is equal to integration 2 QDS. Now guys, here for what is for this section? For section 1 and section 2, what it will be? For section 1, so it is q1 into pi r plus q1 minus q2 into 2r is equal to q2 into pi r plus Q2 minus Q1 into 2R. Can you guys solve this? What do you get? Q1 into pi R plus Q1 minus Q2 into 2R is equal to Q2 into pi R, Q1 minus Q2 into 2R. So what do you get? Q1 minus Q2 will be equal to 0. Okay. Clear or not? From here, what we'll get? Q1 minus Q2 equal to 0, right? So in web, what is your shear flow? Q1 minus Q2, which is what? Q. So what I'll get from here? Q1 minus Q2 into pi R plus Q1 minus Q2. If I take this side, I'll get 4R is equal to 0. So what we get? Q1 minus Q2 into pi R plus 4R equal to 0. So this cannot be 0. So what 0? Q1 minus Q2 is 0. Right. So Q1 minus Q2 is what? Your Q. And it is what? 0. Is it clear to everyone? So finally, what we got here? We got Q1 minus Q2 into pi R plus 4R is equal to 0, right? Now we know this cannot be 0. So what is 0? Q1 minus Q2 is 0, which is what? Shear flow in your mid web, right? Because it is like this. This section is like this. This is one section. This is another. So here you have Q1 and here you have Q2. So mid web is what? Q1 minus Q2. Clear? No, common web thickness is 2T or T, or they didn't mention. I think thickness is, They didn't mention about thickness, I think. Or even if they mention, I will share the exact original question. I don't think they have mentioned anything about thickness here. Okay, fine. So let's see the last question. This question. So what is given? A thin walled rectangular rectangular what? Hey man, this guy has written this also in the language mistake. Rectangular cross section subjected to equal and opposite forces as shown in the figure. Shear stresses along AB. Along this section AB is what? Constant, non-zero, varies linearly, varies parabolically, or zero? What is the answer, guys? What is the question? There is one cross section. It is subjected to couple. And along this AB, what is your shear stress? They are asking. It is constant, non-zero, zero, varies linearly, varies parabolically. So first of all, yeah, constant, non-zero, I think the answer. Let's see how. See, first of all, this couple will produce torque. So your T will be what? P into this distance is A, right? So P into A is what your couple. Now from Bradwedo theory, we know T equal to what? 2AQ. Q is what? Tau into T, right? Now thickness is constant. Thickness is constant. So what is your T? It is P into A upon 2A by T. Right? So it is what? Thickness is constant, right? This thickness is constant. So my shear stress is what? Constant, non-zero. Is it clear? I think it was discussed in group also sometime back. So guys, done from my side. We have discussed, you know, all the all the questions which is from thin walled torsion part, thin walled torsion. All the concepts also we have discussed. So this is this part is quite easy, and it is your answer is B. Why? Because shear stress is what? P into A upon 2AT. Thickness is uniform of section AB, so my tau is constant, non-zero. Now you know there are some, you know, solution book available in market. They have solved it wrongly. They do not understand the difference between couple and shear force. Okay, couple and shear force. So please do not follow the answer key available in, you know, in Google for this. What is the answer? B is the answer. Okay, so that's it